Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. I'm Ben Giron, the founder and CEO of MAC Product. What is it that we do in MAC Product? We produce chemicals. As you can see, this is our own brand of dishwashing liquid. We also teach people how to manufacture chemicals. Hence, we decided to launch this online formulation training program. In this video, I'll show you how to make dishwashing liquid. It's a formulation that I'm going to give out. If you're stopping by the channel for the first time, make sure that you subscribe. Smash that like button for me. Consider dropping us a comment below as well. You know how much we do value subscribers here. We make sure that we take time to go through each and every comment and we reply. That's it. So what is it that I'm going to show you in this video? As I say, I'm going to show you how to make dishwashing liquid, okay? Is actually this formulation that I'm going to share with you, okay? So we're going to get to our usual board whereby I'm going to show you the ingredients, okay? I'm going to state them for you. I'm going to show you in which sequence to mix them and the related amount of each. And also, there are a couple of things that I'll be explaining all along, okay? All along the video. So make sure that you remain tuned till the end so that you can learn this. Here we go, okay? This is the formulation of which I'm going to go through, state ingredient, show you in which sequence to mix them and the related amount of each. That's it. So what are the ingredients you need for you to manufacture dishwashing liquid? The ingredients are, we do have water, okay? We have caustic soda, we have sulfonic acid, we have sless, we have urea, which is a clarity agent, okay? It will actually give clarity to your product, that's it. We do have CDE, which is a foam booster. We do have perfume. We do have NP9, which is a wetting, thickening, and foam booster agent, okay? We do have formalin, we do have dye and salt. That's it. And you need to make sure that you mix ingredient following this sequence, please. Okay? You mix ingredient following this sequence. It means what? The first ingredient should be water. Okay? Then you go to caustic, soda, so on. You actually follow them all. And the last ingredient is salt. Okay? There is something particular about this salt. The salt you're going to put into your product should be fine salt, okay? I do have fine salt with me. I'm just going to show you, okay? This is fine salt. I also have it in a 5 kg bucket, okay? This is fine salt, even super fine, okay? That's it. You need to take that into account. Now let us go to the ratio of mixing, okay? Water should be 69% of your total volume, okay? Caustic soda should be 0.9% of your total volume. Sulfonic acid that should be using here should have a strength of 98% and it should be 8% of your total volume. Sless should have a strength of 25% and it should be 16% of your total volume. Urea should be 1.5% of your total volume. CDE should be 1% of your total volume. Perfume should be 1% of your total volume as well. NP9 should be 0.6% of your total volume. Formalin should be 1% of your total volume. On the dye, as you can notice, we just put QS, okay, which means quantity sufficient. That will depend on you, okay? You put the dye according to the appearance that you want to give to your product. That's it. And salt should also be 1% of the total volume. And there's something I'd like to tell you, by the way, okay? While manufacturing your dishwashing liquid, you need to make sure that your pH should be around 8, okay? Your product should have a pH of 8. Why? Because in a case of excessive pH, what will happen after some few days, your product will actually change the color, okay? It will turn into becoming yellow. Why? Because of excessive pH. That's it. And we've been victim of this as well, okay, when we first started. But as much as you manufacture, you actually become better with time, okay? Some of these things, they don't even tell you. You just discover them as time goes on, okay? So while manufacturing your dishwashing liquid, you need to take into account checking the pH, okay? It should be around 8. That's very important. Now, let's consider making about 5 liters of dishwashing liquid, okay? The first ingredient to consider is water. Water should be 69% of your total volume. I'm at 69% of 5 liters. It's 3.45 liters, okay? So we consider 3.45 liters of water. That's it. The next ingredient is caustic soda. Caustic soda should be 0.9% of the total volume, okay? This would be about 45 grams of caustic soda out of our 5 liters that we manufactured. That's it. The next ingredient is sulfonic acid. This should be 8% of the total volume, okay? How much is 8% of 5 liters? We need to consider about 400 mils of sulfonic acid. That's it. The next ingredient is slush. Slush should be 16% of the total volume, okay? Out of our 5 liters, we need to consider about 800 grams of slush. That's it. The next ingredient is urea. This should be 1.5% of the total volume, okay? We need to consider about 75 mils of urea out of our 5 liters that we manufactured. That's it. Then CDE should be 1% of the total volume. So we need to consider 5 mils of CDE. Perfume should be 1%, 50 mils of perfume. NP9 should be 0.6%, okay, of the total volume. We need to consider 30 mils of NP9. The next ingredient is formalin. Formalin should be 1% of the total volume, okay? 1%, how much is 1% of our 5 liters? Is actually 50 mils. So we consider 50 mils of formalin. As we said, when it comes to the dye, it's QS, okay? Which means quantity sufficient. So you push your dye according to the appearance that you want to give to your product. And then the next ingredient is salt, okay? For 5 liters of dishwashing liquid, you need to consider 1% of the total volume. This is about 50 grams of salt. So by doing this, you obtain your 5 liters of dishwashing liquid. 5 liters of dishwashing liquid. That's it. Thank you guys for watching. Make sure that you subscribe to the channel. As I always say, that there is a lot to learn from here. Trust me. Make sure that you like our videos, okay? Share them. Also suggest the channel to people with the interest of learning. Thank you guys for watching. Make sure that you subscribe and see you on the next video.